What's up, NGT? Welcome back. This is iDanish Freak. And yeah, I got blackouts. I got it on release date. Sorry, not for uploading. I didn't had the time. Yeah, you know, I just didn't want to upload something before I got something good for you. So, I am at this time. I don't know what level I am actually in this game, but right now on the Xbox, I am on level 43 or something, 44. And yeah, so far this game has been really great to me, and I like it a lot. It's very, it's not really sniper competitive thingy, but I can still snipe though a little bit. I'm getting into it a little bit more, and sniping is actually, it's okay. It's not that amazing, but yeah, I'm just gonna try, see if I can like get through it. Anyway, I want to say firstly. The kill streaks are not that overpowered, and the Galil I'm using right now is a perfect starter weapon if you're starting on the game. Use this gun, camp a little, not that much. I don't like to camp that much, but yeah, as you can see, I'm camping a little bit, and that's just strictly because if you want to survive and have a good KD in this game, you need to camp a little in this game, because it takes really. It takes a really good amount of bullets to like really kill them. So Galil is not that overpowered, and it's fast shooting, and if you put on a standard max and the suppressor with Warlord, and Warlord does two attachments, that's what this like kind of bling. And then I think you'll be right about that. Alright. My kill streaks are 5, 7, 8. It's the Blackbird that can you can see enemies on the map where they're going, like not just spy plane that comes up every 3 seconds, you can see where they are. The Blackbird does that, you can see them all the time on the map for a short for amount of time. The attack helicopter is, you know, from every other game, hovers around shooting. And napalm strike, it's an airstrike coming over with some napalm, and it burns like for 10 to 15 seconds, and if any enemies like go into it, they die. So yeah. Anyway, so normally before I start playing, and I go into combat training or whatever it's called, and I take a little few rounds. That's a really good idea, actually, I think, combat training, because you're gonna need it's a really good warm up. It's a good warm up for me taking on Renarin and like playing against them. It's a really good warm up even for me. And I enjoy playing this game. Yeah, there's not such thing as a bad things to say about it. Even though it's a new game, so there are some small bugs and all that stuff that needs to be fixed. So, like, give it the time, guys. Even though you say, oh, this is shit, give it the time. It just came out. They need to make the patches out now. So. Give it a little bit of time now, like, give it until next year, like, play for this, like, this 2 months, and let's see where it takes you. You might be really good, and all that stuff. Yeah, so, like, I have nothing more to say about that subject right now, but, anyway, I want to talk about three things now. I want to talk about GB, theater mode, and perks. So, we're going to start off with GB. You're going to see GB matches from me with my friends. I'm gonna commentate over those where we win, and what we did right, and what I or they did wrong. So yeah, you can like try and get a little bit more into GB, because this is a really good GB game. And don't worry about saying like, oh, but we always lose because it's dispute and we don't have a capture card. Welcome to Black Ops, my friends. Theater mode, second subject. Theater mode is basically it records your game like Halo Reach and Halo 3. I just think it's a little bit more better. I use theater right now. This is not taken from theater, it's from directly from a capture card. But I use theater to like save small clips of not recording or a whole gameplay. Like this morning I got a 5-man spray, and to do funny things with my friends I recorded and all that stuff. And the last thing, the perks. I saw a guy on NGT Games saying that Ninja Pro. Yes, Ninja Pro, I have it. I have it now. I just tried it out like a couple hours ago. And he's right. Even though with Ninja Pro, you can't really hear the enemies anyway. I think, to answer his questions, I think it's a little bit of a patch that needs to be fixed. Because even though they have Ninja Pro, well, not, there's just Ninja, and you have Ninja Pro, you still can't hear them. Like, I need to turn my BGs really, really loud. And it really hurts my ears if I have to turn them that loud before I can, like, slightly hear them. And that's X-Force. I don't know what about Astros or Tritons or anything like that. Or Skull Candies. So, if you know anything about it, just tell me about it. Just leave it in the comments. Are Ninja Pro, can you hear them, even though they have Ninja on? Like Ninja Pro. If you don't know what Ninja Pro does, or Ninja exactly, Ninja does move silently, like Dead Silence in Call of Duty 4. And Ninja Pro is like Sitrep. Sitrep Pro. Well, just Sit, yeah, Sitrep Pro from Modern Warfare 2. And Sitrep Pro, did, you can hear footsteps louder. Anyway, as you can see, I'm raping so badly on this map. Okay, perks. The perks are really good balanced out, I think. And I have nothing against it. So, yeah. What am I? I'm 2065 at 5.20 KD. So that's actually pretty good for me. Well, if you got the game, guys, or don't, I say try it out. Have a laugh with it. And this has been iDanishFreak. Oh, remember to put down what you want to see from me in Black Ops. Anyway, this has been iDanishFreak. Peace.
Hey guys, we're on Facebook. Check the description of this video for the link to our new Facebook application. Subscribe and get our latest video updates posted right on the wall on your own Facebook page.